Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be doing a holiday makeup tutorial. This is the look, obviously. I tweeted that I was going to like do this on Twitter and everyone was like, yeah, so that's what I'm doing today. I wanted it to be like kind of glam, like always, and still like holiday, so you could totally wear this for Thanksgiving if you want. You can wear it for Christmas, probably not New Year's. Well, I mean you could, but like I'm going to do a full New Year's glam. It's gonna be super glittery as always. It's gonna be really fun. I'm already having that in my mind. Juices are flowing for that. It's gonna be really good. If you guys will just take a quick minute to subscribe, it's right down here. I think it's on this side. So yeah, be sure to subscribe to my channel if you guys want. I set up a backdrop, so I really tried for this video. It's not just my dorm room, which is, I'll show you. It's my dorm room over there. I literally just set up a backdrop because I want it to look good. So be sure to subscribe to my channel right down here, and also be sure to follow me on Instagram. My username is @tori_sterling_. Without further ado, let's get on to the look. Sorry if you guys can see that like bump right there. I'm in a dorm room, as you guys know, and that's my towel rack, so I literally like can't take that bump out or else I would. So let's just ignore that and work with what we have. So also I'm gonna be addressing like all of this in my next video, so be on the hunt for it. But anyway, my friend Carly's in the room. Do you want to come say hey? So I know I've talked about this before, but I don't know if I've ever like used it in a video. This is the Glam Glow Glow Starter Mega Illuminating Moisturizer. I really want my skin to be dewy today, and if you guys know me, that's kind of weird because I actually hate my skin to be dewy. But like for this glam, I kind of want it to be. This is like the best stuff ever. It smells like so good. For me, it smells like Jamaica because I wore this every single day in Jamaica. And it smells like pina coladas and like pineapple and like so tropical to me. My God, this brings back so many good memories. Okay, but it's seriously like the best ever. So you just need a little bit. I guess that's kind of a lot. Right now I'm using my viewfinder as a mirror, so sorry about that. But I'm just like obsessed with this. You can totally just put this like on high points of your face if you don't want your whole face to be glowy and dewy, because this really does like make your whole face glowy. Like I put this on and then I asked Matt, I was like, do you like my moisturizer? And he was like, you look so sweaty. So he doesn't get it. It really like, look at that. It makes you so dewy and so glowy. So if you aren't a glow type of girl, you will absolutely hate this product. But if you're like Jaclyn Hill, Nikki Tutorials level of glow, you will love this. For foundation, like I said, I really want my skin to be dewy and glowy, so I'm gonna take the CoverGirl Ready Set Gorgeous in 110. I've been sleeping on this foundation, but I don't know why, because I'm obsessed with it. And I'm gonna actually mix in a little bit of the Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector in the shade Opal, and I'm blending this in with an e.l.f. brush. I honestly don't even know what style this is, but I've been using this lately and it's so good. Like wow, it's really really good. I'm pretty sure it's probably like $5 max. It's just like a stippling brush, and I don't know why it's really good, but it just like blends everything in really nicely and no brush strokes are left behind, which is something I really admire in a good brush. I've kind of veered away from using my beauty blender with foundations just because it makes everything like so wet looking. I don't know, like I know it's supposed to give like a dewy illuminated look, but sometimes it just makes it look cakey and wet, like you just went swimming. I don't know, like mine isn't even that wet either. Like I know a lot of people are like, oh, your beauty blender sweat. It's like not though, it's really just damp. For concealer, I'm gonna stick in the whole drugstore realm, and this is the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer. This is like one of the best out there. This is like a perfect dupe for NARS Creamy Concealer. It's really, really good. I also have yet to try the Tarte Shape Tape. When I go home and I go to Sephora, because there is not a Sephora in Alabama. There is, it's in JCPenney's, but I'm never over there. So when I go home and I go to Sephora, I'm going to go pick it up. And then to bake, I'm going to use the RCMA No Color Powder.
Just the ones you want.
For the eyes, I'm first going to take this color Power Play from the Tarte Lip Palette. This is the original one. It's all matte. And with this, I'm just going to put it on the outer corner of my crease, kind of dragging it out a little bit, and then also bringing it all the way into the inner corner. Oh, I'm using a MAC 224, by the way. Then I'm going to take this Coastal Suns brush. I really don't know what model this is because it doesn't say anything on the handle. It's very equivalent to a MAC 217, so if you have a MAC 217, go in with that. I'm going to go in with this shade right here called Multitasker. And this I'm going to focus on the outer corner. I'm going to go in and define it in a little bit. Right now I'm just focusing on placing the color here. So I'm using this brush because it has a flat side and it has a round fluffy tip. So I can layer the color on, but then I can go in and I can blend it into the outer corner and continue to do that. It's like a little bit of a wing shape, but like I said, I am gonna go back in and define it, but I'm keeping this on the outer corner. Don't be afraid to use your fingers to blend because honestly, your fingers do a really, really good job. So sometimes like over here, you see how that little corner is just out a little bit too far, especially from this angle? My finger can really blend that out better than a brush can. Now I'm gonna go in with this angled brush. This is also from Coastal Suns. Just any angled brush will do. I'm gonna take that same color Multitasker. And now I'm just gonna create a wing with this shadow. I'm just connecting. And then with any flat angled brush, I'm just going to go ahead and layer this color on. If you can tell, I'm just doing very light motions and like flicking it in. So I don't want it to get too heavy too quick. I want it to be a gradual fade. And then once that color's on, I'm gonna go back in with the Coastal Suns brush and buff it out a little bit. So you see the difference between the two eyes? So this one is like a little more dramatic of an edge, and when we finish it, it's gonna look really dope. And then this one is a much more natural version, so you could do either of the two. So I'm gonna add a little pop of color so it's not so expected and like neutral and stuff. So this is the L'Oreal Infallible Eyeshadow in Amber Rush. And with this, I'm just gonna pat it right in the center of my lid. So then for the inner corner, I'm going to go in the Modern Renaissance palette, and I'm going to take this shade right here, Vermeer, I think that's what it's called, something like that. And then for gel liner, I'm going to use Tardist by Tarte. If you guys follow my Instagram, you know this is literally like the only liner that I ever use. It's the best ever. A trick for making gel liner go on a little bit easier is to use a brush that you just always cleaned. So this is just the brush that it came with. I really like this brush, and I always use the MAC Spot Cleaner, and every time before I go in and line my eyes, I clean it real quick so it's kind of a little bit wet. Works really well. For lashes today, I'm going to use the kind of hard to show up. They are the Ardell Wispies. These are like going on day 7 or something. I reuse my lashes until they literally can't go no more. So like one pair of lashes could last me about 2 weeks. But before I go with the lashes, I'm going to take the Tarte Lights Camera Lashes Masky. So while I wait for my glue to get tacky, I just like to finish off the powder of my face. So I'm wiping away the bake. And then under my eyes, I go in with the NARS Stay Luminous All Day Powder Foundation, and this is in the shade Mont Blanc. Oh, I'm waiting till the moon spun around me, then And then all over the rest of my face, I use the Neutrogena Skin Clearing Mineral Powder. For the lower lash line, I'm going to take Multitasker, put that on the outer corner, connecting it up to the wing. I'm keeping it just on the outer half. And then I'm going to take a little bit of Power Player again. That was the first shade. And I'm just going to smudge that right underneath Multitasker and bring it in a little bit. Since I want a little extra glam in there, I'm going to throw in a little glitter liner on the inner corner. This is Midnight Cowboy by Urban Decay. I'm gonna run a little bit of black liner on my waterline. This is the CoverGirl Perfect Point Plus black liner. And just a little bit of lower lash mascara to balance out the look. I'm keeping it mostly on the outer corner because I want the inner corner to have, you know, that glitter. So for bronzer, I'm gonna go in with Hoola by Benefit. And I'm gonna warm myself up. Oh, this is a MAC 135. The numbers like wore off, so I have to like really look at it. I used to be able to like memorize every single MAC brush because it was like the only thing I did with my life was like memorize makeup. So I was able to name every single MAC brush, every single eyeshadow, every single OPI nail polish. Like it was my thing. But the highlight today that I'm going to use is the Mary Luminizer by The Balm. This, to me, screams the holiday season. I don't know why I don't use it any other time of year except for the holidays. It's just so, like, looks like an ornament on a tree. I don't know why. I just think this is so holiday. Too much of this, though, and you really look pale. Like, this highlighter can really, like, wash you out if you're not careful. It's such a bad habit of mine. I put my highlight, like, way too close to my under eyes. I don't know why. I just, like, can't stop myself from doing it. The blush that I'm using today is Flower Child by Becca. I've had this in my travel makeup bag since the summertime, and I haven't used that since the summertime. So this is my first time using it in so long. I miss this shade. It's just so cute. I never put enough blush on, like ever, 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 ever. It's a really bad habit. I have a super light hand with blush, because I feel like too much blush looks so bad. But then I see people like Jaclyn Hill and she has a ton of blush on. She always looks amazing. Okay, and then last but not least is lips. So for lips, I'm going to use the Smashbox Always On Liquid Lip in the shade Boss, spelled B-A-W-S-E, not B-O-S-S, because everyone's extra and they can't spell things normal. I chose this one because it's a little bit more of a pink undertone of a red. The other red I was between is a little bit more orange. Unfortunately, to school with me, I didn't bring like a perfect red lip, so this is all that I have to work with. But if I were to, like, if I was at home and I had like all my reds with me, I'd choose one that had a little bit of a darker and a blue undertone to it. So because of that, I'm going to be pairing it with a darker lip liner. This is the NYX Lip Color Dark Soul. This liquid lip formula is like the best ever because it doesn't settle into like fine lines on your lips. It really just sits like on top of your lips, but it dries on your lips so it doesn't transfer. It's so great, and it's like super lightweight feeling. It's honestly like the best liquid lipstick formula out there. So if you guys are looking for good liquid lips, I would definitely recommend the Smashbox ones. But I'm gonna do my hair, change real quick, and I'll be right back. So I hope you guys all enjoyed this tutorial. If you guys did, be sure to give it a thumbs up and also let me know in the comments down below what other videos you guys want. If you guys do recreate this look, as always, please tweet me pictures. I love seeing it. And yeah, if I don't talk to you guys before Thanksgiving, have a wonderful Thanksgiving and happy Black Friday. Bye guys.